Hey everyone, welcome to my Solitaire Klondike tutorial. Today, on the first episode, we're going to talk about the rules for the software and our goals and steps for what we're trying to accomplish in this tutorial. Now, I want to start with a simple introduction for anyone who's never played Solitaire before. So, Solitaire is a card game, a solo card game, where you play with 7 piles, 4 foundations, and 1 stock slash waste stack. Now, this is your stack right here. So the stack is where you're drawing your card and you flip a card to the waste when you're trying to move it into your deck. And with these 7 piles, you're trying to basically, the goal of the game, what you're trying to accomplish is to move all the cards sorted from starting from the ace all the way to the king into these 4 foundation piles. Now, obviously you cannot just drag them in one by one. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna organize your cards in these 7 piles first. And when you're organizing, the general rule is that you're going to have to put a black card on a red card, and the black card has to be 1 lower than the red card. And if the pile is empty, then the only card you can move to that pile is a king. So for example, I would move this 2 card to this 3 red of hearts card right over here. Now, not every game is technically solvable, but this is a skill-based game. So what we're going to be trying to do is write this game in C++. And a few things I want to talk about is that, one, the definition. So these are going to be called piles for us. We're going to call these piles, and within each pile we're going to have cards. This is going to be called our stock, this is going to be called our waste, and these are going to be our 4 suits. That we're going to be writing this, the rules we're going to be writing with is we're only going to use 1 deck of cards, and we're going to use 7 piles, starting with one card at the pile one, 2 cards at the pile 2, 3 cards at the pile 3, and so on. You're not able to move unrevealed cards, so the top card in each deck is unrevealed until you move a card in that deck. And we're going to be playing with 24 cards in our stock, and every time you shuffle through the stock, it's going to reset, so we're going to have to waste 2 moves. That's just the rules we're going to be playing with. Now, for our steps for this program, first we're going to set up some types in our structures for our decks, cards, piles, and so on. So this is just so we're easily able to retrieve information about a deck or about a pile or about a card. Then we want to create some functions to initiate a game. So this includes shuffling the deck and distributing the cards to each pile and putting the rest into the stock. We want to create some functions for the moves. So for example, from a pile to a foundation, turning the stock, and so on. And we also, I didn't add this here, but we also want to add our inputs from the console. So we want to write some sort of formatting for a move so that when we type something into the console, we can pull out a move on the board. And we also want to print out that board. And we also want to define some over game over states. So either there are no moves left for us to play that are meaningful, or we've moved all the cards into our 4 foundations and we've won the game. And lastly, which is the most fun for me, we're going to make a basic AI to play the game for us. So we're basically going to write a very basic rudimentary software to just play all the moves or play a move for us and win the game. And that's about it. Let me know if you have any questions or suggestions in the comments, and I look forward to going on this tutorial with you guys.